It is considered good clinical practice to show caution to the risk of serious pathology with any new episode of low back pain or if the symptoms appear to be aggravating. The list of spinal pathologies most commonly agreed upon includes the following four conditions: vertebral fractures, axial spondyloarthritis, infection, and primary and secondary tumors. But you should also be aware of any progression in neurological symptoms related to lower back pain. This includes the cauda equina syndrome, compromised nerve roots, and neuropathies. The list of clinical findings that should lead clinicians to warrant further investigations has been referred to as red flags. While this was earlier simply a list of signs and symptoms based on consensus or expert opinions, research has now shown that the risk of missing serious pathology may be reduced only if sign and symptoms from the patient's history and their symptoms are clustered together rather than used as standalone findings. In fact, research suggests that finding any so-called red flag in isolation neither increases nor decreases the risk of having a serious pathology. According to the existing research, these are the clusters which provide the best chance of finding serious pathologies in the clinic. For fracture, it is age above 70 years, long-term use of corticosteroids, a trauma, and bruising. For malignancy, the risk increases significantly if you had had cancer before or if there's a strong clinical suspicion. Infection should be suspected if there's been previous infections combined with fever, shivering, or sweating. For the cauda equina syndrome, the signs and symptoms are generally not sensitive or specific. So in this case, any suspicion should lead to further investigation or a second opinion. In the next video, you will learn more about nerve root compression, radiculopathy, and neuropathic pain.